cord cutters.
Thank you.
Sam. You can do it. Strong, Sam.
Thank you. You okay?
BB stress levels are increasing. Remember, if it suffers an autotoxemic attack, it won't be able to help you detect VTs. To keep it calm, avoid sudden movements and stay as far away as you can from VTs and other threats.
You can do it. Sam, do you remember your own birth? Me, I remember being inside the womb. I wasn't alone. I could hear my mother's heartbeat, hers, and Lochna's. We were conjoined twins, one and the same. But then they tried to separate us with surgery. The operation was successful. We were still one. We knew each other's thoughts without saying a word. My joy was her joy. Her pain was my pain. The sins was too great for us to overcome. Some might call it a kind of telepathy. Divided our body, joined in spirit. We had a beach just for us. One we shared. Our own private chiral network, you might say. With cupids, we can build one that will let everyone share what Lochna and I have. I saw it all laid out before me after I signed up with Bridges. A network that could unite everyone, no matter how scattered or different. It would make us whole. It wouldn't be about bringing people into line. It would be about bringing them into the fold. Where they would share and share alike. I knew I could change the world. Sally's help, we finalized the Cupid design. But after the attack and the birth, everything changed. For the first time in my life, Wakna wasn't there. But I'm not alone anymore. I can feel her again. She's close. Thank you, Sam. I feel whole again. You and me, sis. Me and you. I'm sorry, Wakna.
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Lincoln, no. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Good to hear your voice again. I shouldn't have kept you in the dark. Tried to save her. I couldn't. You don't have to say it anymore. Lakna, you need to fix his Cupid. I couldn't save our child, but you can save our world. Only you. I love you. You hear me? Forever. And always. Make the world whole, okay? Just like you make me. All that she went through, I had no idea. I thought she'd severed our bond on purpose, that she stole our child and ran. I fixed your Cupid like she asked. The limiter should be functioning properly now. There is one thing. Before I sat down to work, I took a long, hard look at the code. I'm pretty sure someone's tweaked it. Either that, or my memory's going to pieces.
Someone rewrote your code?
Rewrote might be overstating it. Let's just say it wasn't the latest version I released. And yet, because of it, I was finally reunited with Malingan. Could be we found our culprit already. She died beneath the rubble, with our child still inside her. Her ka passed over to the other side, but her ha remained, bound to our dead daughter. She knew all of this, of course. That's why she kept one cuff loose. Didn't want anyone seeing her vitals. Shame she couldn't use her favorite invention. She did all that to keep me and our daughter safe. This? I can hear you. We're whole again. We're one. Like before in the womb, remember? Malingan. Akna.
Thanks to you, Edgenot City is finally within reach. And you, Lachna, your work will help ensure that the Chiron network remains online. Together, we might just make it all the way west. Now then, Sam, there's something else you ought to know. We've been studying the data from when you claim you encountered those soldiers. We had audio, which doesn't paint a complete picture on its own, but the languages, the names, and terms we picked out, the munitions we could identify, everything seems to indicate that you were on a battlefield over 100 years ago. World War I, to be precise. It wasn't a dream, wasn't a hallucination. Maybe you were spirited away to another dimension or something. And given the time discrepancies, maybe you were sent to a beach. Can't say anything for certain. That said, I've never heard of a beach turned into a battlefield. But beaches are shaped by the will of the people who inhabit them. Perhaps Hartman can offer a more rational explanation. Beaches are his specialty. Unfortunately, he's still outside the Chiral network. Anyway, get some rest. No use dwelling on questions we can't answer yet. Good morning, Sam. Blood collection complete. Thank you for your generosity.
Sam, the junk dealer seems to have realized that your skills are the real deal. He's put in a new order with your name on it. Head to his shelter and do the honors, would you?
Looking for this? Surprise! Fragile warped me here. I finally got to visit the beach. Well, her beach. Don't worry. I didn't come all this way for the sightseeing. Your beloved BB has a serious issue. You may recall me explaining that these incubators connect BBs via the chiral network to their still mothers back at HQ. Bridge babies are quite literally bridges between this world and the other side. Their place is not here with us, nor with the BTs over there. They belong precisely in between, with no greater affinity for one world or the other. But BB-28 here has been leaning further and further towards the world of the living. Towards you, Sam.
It's because we're partners.
Partners? Sam, a BB's a tool, not a human being. Bridge, yes. Baby, no.
So tell me what the problem is.
This tool, this weapon, is transforming into a living being. It's gaining weight. Its brain activity is increasing. It's accumulating memories. BB-28 is becoming self-aware, becoming an actual child.
Doesn't sound like a problem to me.
It's hardware, Sam. Manufactured for a purpose. A purpose it cannot fulfill outside the pod. There is a 70% risk of catastrophic failure simply in removing it. Which hardly matters, because at this point, it'll cease functioning within a couple of days.
Cease functioning?
That's right. Not even the pod will be enough. It'll be bricked.
What do we do?
We reset it. You'll have to leave it with me, of course. I'll cut the cord that links the two of you and then perform an operation that reconnects it to the other side. Think of it as a little tug to correct its alignment. To put it back where it belongs, right between the world of the living and the dead. But like I said, you'll have to be without it for a while.
You're sure this'll work?
Of course. One catch, though. The surgery may erase its memories.
Erase? You'll forget me?
Relax. The BB will still function as intended. You just have to trust me. Come on. I'm telling you, it's like a game. Just select retry and start again! And this is why I hate these things. Sam. I was already filthy from my trip through the beach, but now your BB has added insult to injury. In here. It's just you and me. No audio records of what we say. No video for lip reading analysis. Get closer. Die Hardman cannot know of this. Understood? I've been doing some digging into the first BB experiments. Officially, they were suspended by the government following a void out which claimed the life of the then acting president. Documents were shredded. BB technology banned, yes? But obviously, the experiments continued in secret, on the direct orders of President Strand.
Bridget?
The BBs were essential to solving the mystery of the Death Stranding. Oh, she had big plans for them. They weren't designed just to be BT detectors. She wanted to incorporate them into the chiral network to facilitate travel to the beach. But none of her plans ever came to fruition. And now BB Tech has fallen into terrorist hands.
What's Die Hardman's part in this?
I'm afraid to find out. I don't know how long he was working for Strand. I don't even know his real name or his face. I thought you might. Since you two go further back.
He was already wearing a mask when I met him. Something about burning his face.
Right. Sorry. Any data we have from back then is classified at the highest level. As far as I know, the director is the only one with clearance. But the chiral network presents a new opportunity. By compiling fragmented data in the public domain from all across the country, I might be able to piece together a little more of the puzzle. Be careful, Sam. They're watching. Well, Sam, you're a good sport. I'll give you that. Still, it's a fine way to get out of doing the laundry.
Just fix BB, all right?
Oh, no. You'll be doing the fixing. I'd never manage without your help. Check the delivery terminal upstairs for the details. When you're ready, of course.